this GIMP workshop, we're going to create an image with several silhouettes. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the images in the video description. Press Ctrl O to open the image open dialog box. Here we search for the image of the arch and open it. Press Ctrl Shift J to fit the image in the window. Right-click somewhere in the image. Go to Layer, Transparency, and click on Add Alpha Channel. This allows us to have transparency in the layer. Now we go to the toolbox and we activate the Foreground Select tool. Then we go to the Configure tab icon, click on Tool Options menu, and hit Reset All Tool Options. Click Reset. Change the engine to Matting 11 and leave both levels on the default 2. I found out that this option works better at least with these images. Zoom in to the edge of the arch by holding the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. The cursor looks the same as the free select tool. We will click in the arch and stay just a little bit within the stones, like so. It helps to stay close to the edge, but do not cross it. We can click node after node, but we can also drag the cursor to make the selection. With the backspace key, we can undo one or more nodes. When we hold the spacebar down, the cursor changes into the Move tool. We can now, by just moving the mouse, move the image. When we are back at the first node, we hover over it, and when it turns yellow, we click the last node over the first one. Hit Enter to apply the selection. Press Ctrl-Shift-J. We now see something that looks like a quick mask. Do not yet click on the Select button. Now the cursor has changed into the paintbrush. Make the stroke width about 80. Zoom in and paint as much as possible of the areas within the arch. The painting can be done in several strokes. Use the spacebar with the mouse to move the image. Make sure not to paint over the stones of the arch itself, but paint only the inside area. Here too it helps when we stay close to the edge. Here we have to press Ctrl Z to undo the last action. When we think it's enough, we hit Enter. Now this can take a moment to process. We can still paint some more if necessary. For this image, however, we leave the bottom area as it is. When we check the option Draw Background, we can paint, if needed, areas of the background. With this image, however, it's not really necessary. When we're sure that it looks good, we press Ctrl-Shift-J again, and then we click the Select button. Now we have our final selection. Go to Select and click on Grow. We grow the selection with 3 pixels and click OK. This gives us a nice sharp selection. Hit the Delete key to remove the selected area. Press Ctrl-Shift-D to make a duplicate of this layer. Now press Ctrl-I to invert the selection so the arch is selected. Go ahead and drag the black of the foreground color into the image. And now we press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. Activate the Eraser tool. Make the opacity 15. Choose brush hardness 0.25. And make its size about 300. We can now erase a bit of the black to make some of the stones of the arch visible, like so. In the next step, we are going to scale the image. When we click on the chain locks of both layers, we can scale them as one layer. Activate the bottom layer. With this layer selected, we have a better view on what we scale. Zoom out a bit. Make the Unified Transform tool active. Check the option Scale to constrain the proportions when we scale the image. Click in the image and drag only the scale handles to make a good composition, like so. When we click and drag inside the framework, we can move the whole image. Place the opening of the arch just a little bit outside the center. When we feel it's okay, we click Transform. Press Ctrl-Shift-J again. When all this is to our liking, we press Ctrl-Alt-O to open the image open dialog box again. In this way, we open the image of the sunset as a layer. Drag this layer to the bottom of the layer stack. In the next step, we make the Move tool active. Check the option Move the active layer and move the sunset layer to make a good composition. Make sure, however, that it still covers the opening of the arch. Time now to open the image of the pirate. Press Ctrl-O, search for the image and open it. We open this image as a separate image and import it later into the project. Right-click somewhere in the image, go to Layer, Transparency, and click on Add Alpha Channel. Here we will use the Path tool to make the selection because it's much more precise than the Foreground Select tool. Activate the Path tool. Zoom in and click the first node. Now click the next node, but keep the left mouse button down. Draw it out to see the handle and move it around to make a curve. Then we can let go of the mouse. Now click and drag the handle back to its node. Click the next node and again do not release the mouse but drag the handle out to make the curve. Then let go. Now click and drag it back to its node. With Ctrl-Z we can undo our last steps and with Ctrl-Y we can redo them again. For the sake of the tutorial, we'll go fast forward now. Back at the first node, we hover the last node over it. Then we press and hold the Ctrl key, and when we see the chain icon, we click to close the path. In the same way, we select the smaller areas within the trumpet and the arm, like so. And again, we go a bit fast forward. This is done, we press Ctrl-Shift-J and then we click on the button Selection from Path. Go ahead and drag the black of the foreground color into the image. Press Ctrl-I to invert the selection and hit the Delete key to remove the background. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect and hit the B key to get rid of the path. And there we have our silhouette. Now we can drag the thumbnail of the pirate via the thumbnail of the arch into the project. Double-click on the layer's name and rename it Pirate. Hit Enter. Activate the Unified Transform tool again. Zoom out a bit and click in the image. Scale and reposition the pirate like so. Then hit the Transform button to confirm and press Ctrl-Shift-J once more. Now we will open the image of the dog on the treasure chest. Press Ctrl-Alt-O and open this image also as a layer. Zoom out a bit and click in the image. Scale and move the image like so. Then hit Transform. Now in the next step we will again press Ctrl-Alt-O and reopen the image of the pirate ship. The Unified Transform tool is still active, so we can just click in the image. Then we scale this image also and move it to a good composition. Click Transform. Press Ctrl-Shift-D to make a duplicate of this layer. Double-click on the name and rename it Shadow. Hit Enter. In the Tool options, we uncheck the Scale and Shear options. Zoom in a bit, and now we can click in the image and grab the Shear Diamond. We transform the image to make a long shadow, like so. Make sure that the shadow and the ship fit together well. Move it if necessary. Hit Transform again to confirm. Now in the final step we right-click on the shadow layer and hit Add Layer Mask. Initialize the layer mask to White Full Opacity and click Add. In the toolbox we click on the Gradient tool. Choose the gradient Foreground to Transparency. Then we make a gradient in the shadow, like so. Click and drag the begin, the end and the midpoint to make corrections. When it looks good, we press Enter to apply the gradient. Press Ctrl-Shift-J. Now we will do some additional tweaking. Select the pirate layer. Go to Colors, Threshold, and slide the arrowhead all the way to the right to get rid of the remaining white lines. Click OK. Go to the toolbox and activate the Eraser tool. Make the opacity 100. Choose Brush Hardness 100. Make the size about 30. Activate the Arch layer. Zoom in. And erase the areas in the sky, like so. Select the arch copy layer and repeat this erasing. Hit Ctrl-Shift-J for the last time. Make the paintbrush active. Make the size about 100. And check the option Apply Jitter. Now we can make the underground black, like so. And that's how we can make silhouettes, use the foreground select tool and much, much more. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please do not forget to like it and maybe leave a nice comment. Thank you very much for watching.